Oh, we're glad to have you back too. What? Oh, keys. Yes, I'll keep the keys. I think we've had enough locked doors lately.
Evening, General.
Will you say grace, Jimmy?
Jacob was left alone and wrestled with an angel until the breaking of the day, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And the angel said, "Let me go, for the day breaketh." And Jacob said, "I will not let thee go, except thou bless me. Amen." O you angel.
It's a very strange grace, James.
Will you pass the hand, please?
It's from the good book, isn't it?
Of course, didn't you know?
Yes, I knew.
Hand missing?
Please. Then why ask?
I meant it is from the good book and therefore a fitting grace.
Miss Annie?
Thank you.
I'm not so sure about that. There's quite a few things in the good book I shouldn't like to hear just before eating.
Well, fitting in the sense that Jacob's thigh was out of joint, and so is this piggy's.
I declare, James.
Aunt Em?
I should say so. You know my opinion of your pickles.
As the last of them, I'm afraid. I've put up nearly not enough last summer, and this year I intend to.
Reverend peeked into the office this morning. He was complaining about how his hens weren't hatching. That poor fellow was out of joint, I'll say.
I've always suspected those hens.
Of what?
Well, I think they're pups. Has he tried to?
I declare, James, now you're pulling my...
Miss Annie! No. Please, it's a very special day.
It will be when I give in to that.
I've hardly had the chance to welcome her home yet. Captain Keller.
Kate, me and Miss Annie talked about how we shouldn't indulge Helen in these,
What's the child done?
She's learned not to throw things on the floor and kick.
But it's only a napkin. It's not so breakable.
And everything she's learned is.
Mrs. Keller, I know it's painful, but we shouldn't play tug of war for her. Either give her to me or you keep her from kicking.
And what do you wish to do?
Let me take her from the table.
It's only a napkin, she's only a child.
And ask outsiders not to interfere.
I'm a child's aunt!
Well, once hurt Miss Annie, I made all of Helen's favorite foods.
It's a homecoming party, Miss Annie.
She's testing you, you realize.
She's testing you.
And wants to see what will happen. At your hands. I said it was my main worry. Is this what you promised me not half an hour ago?
Well, she's not kicking now.
I'm not learning not to. Mrs. Keller, teaching her is bound to be painful for everyone, but she'll live up to only what you ask of her and nothing more.
She's testing you.
Jimmy?
I have an opinion. I think that...
No one is interested in hearing your opinion.
I'm interested. Of course she's testing me. Let me keep her to what she's learned, and she'll keep on learning to me. Take her out of my hands, and it all falls apart. Be bountiful. It's at her expense. Please pack me more of her favorite foods.
Take her, Miss Annie. Thank you.
I'm afraid you're the problem here, Miss Annie. We'll keep her to what she's learned. You're right there. But I don't see why we should send her from the table. After all, she is the guest of honor.
If she were a seeing child, none of you would
well,
call her...
Well, she isn't. So some compromise has to be made. Bring me her plate, please. There. Some people take some natural aversion to their teachers, and an extra hand can help smooth things out. Now, shall we start all over?
I think we started all over.
What are you doing?
Don't get up! Don't choose anything else out for me. Don't interfere in any way. I treat her like a seeing child because I ask her to see. I expect her to see. Don't undo what I do.
Where are you taking her?
To make her fill this pitcher again. You ever speak to me like that, Arthur? A preacher who works for you?
No, I don't.
Let her go.
What?
I said let her go. She's right. She's right, Kate's right, I'm right, and you're wrong. If you drive her away from here, it'll be over my dead chair. Has it never occurred to you that on one occasion you might be constantly wrong?
Everyone, please sit down. Jimmy, please sit down.
All right, pump. No, she's not here. Pump. W-A-T-E-R. It has a name. Helen. Forever. Ever.